हेलो, दिस इज अमर कुलकर्णी। वेलकम टू माय प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन हॉस्पिटल फार्मेसी। लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशंस आर, आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन, लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू इवेल्युएट द वेरियस रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर द हॉस्पिटल फार्मेसी एंड एनालाइज द मूवमेंट ऑफ मेडिसिन, रॉ मटेरियल एंड पेशेंट। Roadmap of today's presentation. First, we will see the various requirements for the hospital pharmacy. Afterwards, we will see the movement of medicine, raw material, and patient. Before going to start the presentation, here is a reflection spot for you. How will you evaluate the requirements of hospital pharmacy? Just write this question in your notebook as well as the answer of this question, then play the presentation. I think you have written something about this question. Let's move forward. So let's see the requirements of the hospital pharmacy. You can see in this picture, this is a pharmacy where the medicines which are kept in the racks. So here is a requirement of racks which will be used to for keeping the medicines, as well as you can see here, this is a counter. This is also a requirement for the hospital pharmacy for keeping medicines or all other material also. So many requirements for the hospital pharmacy, which is specified under Drug and Cosmetic Act 1945 according to schedule M and N. So in this we'll see the floor space as well as personnel requirement to run the hospital pharmacy smoothly. You can see here the requirements which is available in the Drug and Cosmetic Act under Schedule M and N. So according to Schedule M and N, pharmacy needs floor space and personnel for its smooth functioning, as well as they require various facilities here, the floor space as well as the various equipment. So these are categorized in two group: floor space requirement and equipments requirement. So let's see one by one. So in that, first we will see floor space requirement for hospital pharmacy. So here this floor space which is required for hospital pharmacy is depends on the activities going in the hospital pharmacy. Either that particular hospital pharmacy only dispensing the medicine to the patient, or any manufacturing unit is there. If the hospital pharmacy dispensing only medicines, so for that purpose or that activity, it requires less space, that is at least 205 square feet area. If that hospital pharmacy running any manufacturing unit, so then it requires more space. So the specified floor space required for different activities of hospital pharmacy is given in this table. So you can see wise, see here, activity wise there is a requirement of floor space. Also that floor space is according to the hospital capacity of that particular bed, or bed capacity of that particular hospital. You can see here 50 beds, here has a different space required, 100 bed, here has a different space required, 200 bed, here has a different space required. So it depends on the bed capacity of that hospital or patients which is present in that hospital. Okay, so we can see here the minimum space required in square feet based on the capacity, bed capacity. Okay, so first we will see about the floor space required for 50 beds. So for this pharmacy 50 bed, here 205 square feet area is required, or floor space is required for smooth functioning of the hospital. So here only compounding and dispensing is taking place. Okay, in case of 100 bed, so for compounding and dispensing, here 320 square feet area is required, as well as if that particular hospital pharmacy running in parenteral preparation unit, they require 185 square feet. Okay, so after production, it is necessary to store that particular finished product in a storeroom. So here storeroom is required with area 125 square feet. So here for 100 beds, here total 630 square feet area is required to run the hospital pharmacy smoothly. For 200 bed, here for compounding and dispensing area, or for that particular activity, here at least 495 square feet area is required, as well as if they are running any manufacturing unit, so here also 200 space square feet area is required. For the storage of that finished product, here for storeroom, here 200 square feet area is required, as well as for separate manufacturing area, here 120 square foot area is required, as well as for office and library to maintain all the records of that particular hospital pharmacy, as well as for library. So for both the activities, here 105 square feet area is required, and for the circulation 60 square feet area is required. So for total 200 bed capacity hospital, here total 1180 space is required. So this is about the floor space requirement for the hospital pharmacy. Let's see the equipment's requirement for the hospital pharmacy. So in this, like floor space, Schedule M of the Drug and Cosmetic Act specified requirements of a machinery for various dosage form manufacturing section. These are minimum requirements and a guideline only. So here, whatever the requirement which is required in hospital pharmacy in that particular manufacturing section, so which are specified in Schedule M of Drug and Cosmetic Act 1945. So here selection of that particular machinery is based on how to provide good services to the minimum or with the minimum cost, as well as how the services could be provided efficiently. So generally, the equipments which are classified or which are categorized in two groups, that is fixed equipment and movable equipment. What is mean that fixed equipment? So these are the equipment installed with the building during the construction. So once it is installed, we can't move that particular equipment, called as fixed equipment. For example, counters, cabinets, sink, elevator, etc. So second category, movable equipment. So it is opposite to the fixed equipment, so which is not installed with the building during construction, but it is required in the hospital pharmacy or manufacturing unit. For example, balances, desks, carts and mixtures. So this is about the equipment's requirement in hospital section, hospital pharmacy section. Okay, so let's see the personal requirement. What is mean that personal requirement? So that is the manpower requirement to run that particular department efficiently. Okay. So here the personnel requirement is depends on the activities which is going in the hospital as well as the various processes. Okay. So this activity includes manufacturing. This activity includes manufacturing, testing, distribution, administration, and procurement. So each activity require personnel or manpower to run that particular or to work that particular department in efficient manner or smooth function. So each department or each activity requires a personnel. Okay. So here for that particular activities, M-Pharm qualified person, B-Pharm qualified person, D-Pharm as well as microbiology personnel which is appointed to run that particular department in efficient manner. So here exact number of qualified persons will depend upon the size and the activity of the hospital pharmacy. So this is about the personnel requirement in hospital pharmacy. Let's see the requirement of pharmacist in hospital pharmacy. So these requirements is required in hospital pharmacy to dispense the medicine. So here the requirement of pharmacy is depends on bed size and the activities which is going in the hospital and hospital pharmacy. So in this here the Medical Council of India has given the minimum requirement of the pharmacy. So you can see here, so that depends on the bed size of the hospital. So you can see here this table, the bed size and number of pharmacists required in the hospital pharmacy. If that particular hospital or the clinic doesn't have any inpatient or not have any patient, or they are running the pharmacy only for the outpatient, so at least one pharmacist is required in the hospital pharmacy. If that hospital have 1 to 50 bed size, so here at least 3 pharmacists is required. If that particular hospital have capacity of bed size 51 to 100, 5 pharmacists required. In case of 101 and 200 bed size, 8 pharmacists required. 201 to 300, here at least 10 pharmacists is required for smooth functioning of the hospital. In case of 301 to 500 bed size of that particular hospital, here at least 15 pharmacies are required, and above 500, that is 15 plus 1 for every 100 bed size is required. For example, if hospital have 501 to 600 bed capacity, so 15 plus 1, that is 16 pharmacists are required. If the hospital have 601 to 700 bed capacity, that is 15 plus 2, that is 1 for every 100 beds, that is 15 plus 2, that is 17 pharmacists are required. So this number of pharmacists which is required in hospital pharmacy is based on Medical Council of India. So this is overall about the requirement of pharmacist. Okay, I think you have got the idea or these points, all these points. So let's move to next point, that is movement of medicines. So here we will see the movement of medicine from its purchasing to the dispensing of that particular medicine to the patient. So it starts from the purchasing. So whatever purchase order which is given by that hospital pharmacy to the supplier, so supplier supplies the medicine to the hospital pharmacy, then it comes to pharmacy or medical store. Here actual the checking of that medicines which is done on the basis of the receipt that particular department have got. So after checking these medicines which are sent to the dispensary department where they actually medicines dispensed to the various patient. So here in case of outpatient, here that particular department, that is dispensary department, which is dispensing the medicine to the outpatient on the prescription. So this is about the outpatient. So here directly the outpatient will get the medicine from the dispensary department. But in case of inpatient, here first dispensary send the medicine to the ward or nursing wards. So after that, the particular head of department or the professional which is working in that particular ward will dispense medicine to the inpatient, okay, by any suitable method. So this is about the movement of medicine. So it starts from the purchase and end to the dispensing of that particular medicine to the outpatient as well as inpatient. Next we will see the movement of a material. You can also call it movement of raw material. So here the raw material which is required for the manufacturing of a finished product or final product which is required in the hospital. So here hospital pharmacy running a separate unit of the manufacturing for the production of required medicine. So it starts from the purchase. So whatever the requirements are required in the hospital pharmacy, they are being the purchase order and send it that particular supplier. After that supplier send the material to this particular hospital pharmacy. So here after the purchasing or after getting the receipt as well as material, that material which is kept in the store quarantine, you can see here. So here that particular material which is stored for testing of the that particular raw material, testing of the raw material. So here various quality control test which is doing on that particular raw material and label as under test. So here labeling is done on that particular container, so that sample was taken for the quality control test. If that sample passes all the tests, then it is approved and sent to the for the manufacturing. But in case of any material which has failed that particular test, then it is directly sent to the supplier as a rejected material. So on that particular container there is a label like rejected, and that material which is sent to the supplier. But in case of that particular material passes all the test, then it is labeled as approved material, then it is sent to the main store. After that, whatever the requirements which is received from the production department, then that particular quantity of that raw material which is sent to the production department. So in this production department there is an manufacturing of that particular dosage form. So at the time of manufacturing there is an inner process check. So during the manufacturing, here some test which is doing on that processing product to check either the quality of that particular material, either it is produced in specifications or not. So after that, the complete batch manufacturing, the test which is done on that material, and when it is approved, then it is sent to the goods quarantine area. So here actually the final product which is stored, then here also some quality control tests which are doing to check either that product which is in a required specification or not. And when it is passed the all the tests, then it is sent to the medical store for dispensing of that particular finished product to the patients, either inpatient or outpatient. So this is the overall journey of raw material to the finished product. I think you have got this point. Let's see the next movement of the patient. So here we'll see the movement of patient. So it starts from the entry of patient in hospital at the registration counter to the exit of that particular patient. So here let's see here the registration. So once patient is entered in the hospital, they are coming and at the registration counter. You can see here registration counter. If that patient is old and which are came for the follow-up, then that particular old patient which is sent to the clinical services. If the patient is new, then first it is sent to the casualty for initial checkup. So after that checkup, for that particular patient which is sent to the clinical services for getting the treatment. So you just remember here, see, old patient which is directly sent to the clinical services department, a new patient which is sent after the initial checkup. So here in this clinical services, actually treatment is given, but that treatment is depends on the whatever diagnosis which is done in the laboratory or in the radiology department. Then the patient which is in the clinical services department, that patient is sent to the laboratory testing. So here actually diagnosis of that particular disease is done with the help of blood sample or by using the radiology department. So after getting the report, so here the patient is sent to the clinical services for getting the treatment. So here the treatment is based on the whatever reports he received from the laboratory or testing or radiology department. After that, if there is a necessary to provide or to give any medicine to that particular patient, then here those patients which are working in this clinical services department has written some prescription and given to the patient. Then that patient is coming to the pharmacy for getting the medicines. But in case of that particular patient doesn't require any medicine, then the prescription is not given to the patient. So here the patient which is not prescribed medicine, so they directly comes out from this hospital, that is directly comes out the hospitals. And so this is about the patient who are not prescribed the medicine. But in case of prescribed medicine, so the patient which is coming in the pharmacy for getting the treatment, they are receiving that particular medicines on that prescription. So here pharmacy providing the prescription on the basis, pharmacy providing the medicine to the patient on the basis of the prescription which is provided by the physician. Then he is receiving the medicines, then he is doing the payment, and they will goes out from this particular hospital. But in case of here in the clinical services department, if that particular patient need to admit, then it is directly hospitalized in the patient. So whatever the medicines which are required to that particular patient, so here pharmacies is sent to that particular ward, and from the ward, so it is dispensed to the patient. So after recurring of that particular patient, they are directly doing the payment, and here after the payment here they are discharged out. So this is overall about the movement of a patient in hospital. So if you have any question, you can drop your question in my WhatsApp number, or you can also drop your question or query on my email ID. So thank you for patient listening. Thank you very much.